Hello everyone, I hope you all are fine. Once again, we are back with another lesson of class 5, that is lesson 6, Clever Monkey, page 62. I hope your studies have been going on, and whatever homeworks have been given to you, you are doing them religiously. You should and keep on reading. This is our last chapter for the second monthly. This is the last chapter, and we'll finish it today. First, have a look from where the passage is taken from. It's on page 67. The last part is adapted from based of Jataka tales. So the story that is Clever Monkey, lesson 6, page 62, is adapted from the based of Jataka tales. Now we come back here. We first, as usual, the process that we follow, that we will first read the text. And once we complete the text, we'll go through the meanings while listening or while going through the text. And once we are finished reading the text, we will complete the question answers. So, let's begin. Once upon a time, there lived a monkey on the bank of a river. Right in the middle of the river, there was a small island with many fruit trees. So the first word that you come across here is island, and I hope you know the meaning of island. That means a land totally surrounded by water. This piece of land, there is water around it. So the story begins with a monkey, and the monkey is, as the title suggests, we don't know about the cleverness that he has. But as the story begins, it's about the monkey who lives on the bank of a river, and just around the river, the middle of the river, there is a small island, and the land and what the island does have. The island has many fruit trees. Sweet and juicy fruits grew on the trees. So we also get the information about what kind of fruits are there. So they are very productive ones, they are very juicy, and they are very sweet in taste also. At a distance from the bank, there was a huge rock in the river. So the location of the island is being given, and also is being specified about the island, that the island, what is about the island, the island has a huge rock in the river. I hope you know the meaning. We have already discussed in the previous lesson the meaning of huge is gigantic or colossal. I have given to you the meanings. The opposite word of huge is tiny. Huge মানে হচ্ছে অতি বিশাল, খুব বড়, যার বিপরীত শব্দ হচ্ছে tiny. Tiny মানে হচ্ছে অতি ক্ষুদ্র. A part of it was above water. One day, attracted by the delicious fruits, the monkey jumped to reach the rock and from there leapt onto the island. So here, because of the productivity, because of the beauty of the land, because of the huge fruit trees, delicious fruit trees the island had, the monkey was attracted by it. I hope you know the meaning of delicious. The delicious means very tasty. The word, the meaning is given here also at the end of the lesson. And what does he do? Because he was attracted by the delicious nature of the fruits, he decided that he will go to the island, he will eat them. So he jumped to reach the rock and from there leapt onto the island. Now jump and leapt, almost they have the same sense of meaning. Both of them, they mean that jumped, that means to have a leap. Not so difficult after all, he said to himself. Soon he was enjoying the sweet fruits from the trees. There was hardly any other animal there, so he was in no danger. So here we come across two things. The first that is mentioned at the end of page 62, that how did the monkey proceed to reach the island where he will have the taste of delicious fruits. And the process is being mentioned here, and for him, according to the monkey, the procedure is not at all too much difficult. So that means that he has a likeness to go to that place and have the taste of those delicious fruits. Also, because he enjoyed having those sweet fruits, he decides that he will come there more often. And another reason behind there is that the island, it was out of any kind of danger. The reason behind is that the land or the island having no danger from any other animal. So that means he was safe from being hunted by any other animal. Hence, the monkey decided to visit the island every day. Hence, mane amra jani ekhon theke. From that means from that moment on, the monkey decided that he is and he will be having the taste of the of those delicious fruits from time to time. That means there will be no stopping from him from having the pleasure of having those fruits. On the far bank of the river, a big crocodile lived with his wife. Now we come here, come across here, the second character of the story, and who is that? That is a crocodile. It was a big crocodile, and he lived with his wife. One day, he noticed the monkey crossing the river in his unique way. Unique means one in a way. That means unparalleled. UNPARALLELED. I am spelling the word once again. UNPARALLELED. Unparalleled. That means one in a way. One of a way. Atulonio. Jeta ar kyo korte parbe na. One of a kind. So, because the monkey, he had this unique nature of going to the island, crossing the river to go to the island, the crocodile, he noticed that, he took notice of that going, of that uniqueness. He told his wife, "Did you see him? Let's catch him tomorrow." So because he has to cross the river, maybe for a very, very brief moment of time, for a very short period of time, but still, because he has to cross the river, the crocodile, he thought that he will have a chance, he will take a chance, or he can have the flesh, or he can have the taste of the monkey, and that is what, that desire or that wish, he came across the desire of that wish to his wife. Next morning, however, the crocodile found that catching the monkey was not easy. So the procedure of catching the monkey, it started from the very next morning, but to a very futile way. Futile, F-U-T-I-L-E, futile means fruitless, mane bartho, failure. That the trying of the crocodile to catch the monkey, to have its taste, it did not bring him any success. Who is that him? Him is that crocodile. He failed to have the grip of the monkey. The monkey landed on the rock and in a flash jumped off onto the island. In a flash, the meaning is been given here, within a split moment. That means within a very few seconds, within a very brief time, within a very short time. So because of the quickness, because of the rapidness of the monkey, because of his ability, his style of quick response, the crocodile failed to catch him, and that is why he could not eat the monkey. Hiding behind the rock, the crocodile could only watch him. He returned home without his catch. So the crocodile has to return empty-handed to his nest. Why? Because he has not been able to hunt the monkey down. He has not been able to catch the monkey down because of his ability to move quickly, because of his ability to move rapidly.